As most of you know, this last summer, we lost a great patriot and one of our movement's real heroes. Terry Anderson was one of those larger-than-life people who leaves a lasting impression on everybody he knew. D.A. King, who's the president of the Georgia-based Dustin Inman Society, was a particularly close friend of Terry's. He's going to share some remembrances of Terry, and then we're also going to have a video that Fred Elbel did about Terry and some of his contributions to our cause. So please welcome D.A. King.
I spent considerable time preparing some remarks to remember somebody that I thought the world of. I'm not going to use those remarks. This is considerably harder than I thought it would be. When I just heard Casey say that Terry was gone, it became difficult to speak. Terry was a very dear friend of mine, and I know there's a lot of people in this audience who can say the same thing. I am accustomed to speaking to groups on the technicalities and the law on illegal immigration, much like Michael Cutler did. This is the first time I've ever been uncomfortable up here. This is the first time I've ever seen on the front of a magazine remembering Terry Anderson. Terry Anderson is supposed to be sitting in the back of the room right now, giving me the high sign. Later on, when the event is over, we're supposed to go someplace and have a glass of beer and talk about the day. Terry Anderson has been described quite often as the common man's voice in the illegal immigration battle. I want to assure everyone here that I understand that description, but Terry Anderson was anything but a common man. He was the most uncommon man I have ever met. Terry Anderson was kind and clever, had a perpetual twinkle in his eye. He was humble and generous with his time. He would fly all over the country to speak at a rally simply if someone asked him and could maybe help out with some airfare. Terry Anderson is gone, and that is our great loss. He is irreplaceable. If I may be allowed a little bit of self-indulgence, I met Terry Anderson here at my first writer's conference in 2003. For that, I am forever grateful. For those of you who did not know Terry, it is something that I'm very sorry to tell you. You missed a great American. I was told to relate some stories on Terry, and I don't want to take up too much time. I want to get out on time, and I want Fred's video to act as the picture is worth a thousand words. But Terry was one of the most curious people that I have ever met. One time, Terry flew from California to Atlanta, where I live, to do a speaking presentation for 5 minutes. And the event was early in the morning, and we stayed up late the night before chatting at my house. And the phone rang at 5 o'clock in the morning, and it was the woman who had organized the event telling me that it had been canceled because of an ice storm. Now, for those of you who don't live in the East, an ice storm is something to behold if you've never seen one. Terry Anderson, a Los Angelino, had never seen an ice storm. So I went and woke up Terry at 5 o'clock in the morning. I said, "Hey, Bubba, we're not going to the event. Go back to sleep." He said, "Why?" I said, "There's an ice storm." He didn't know what I was talking about. Terry would not let me go back to sleep at 5 o'clock in the morning. We had to get up and go walking around my neighborhood to see what an ice storm looked like for 2 hours. Then we came back, and I wanted to go back to bed. Still, Terry and my wife, Sue, were in their sweats watching old movies until noon. Terry was an old movie buff. He had a wide variety of interests in addition to stopping illegal immigration. But in this room, that part of Terry should not be forgotten. Terry spoke up because he could see his community changing by the day because of the organized crime of illegal immigration and the refusal of our government to secure our borders and equally apply our laws. I am so proud to have known him. It's very difficult for me to explain. He was a truly funny and entertaining man, and for people who only heard him on the radio, please know that he was exactly an entirely different when he was not on the radio than when he did his very famous show. For 10 years, Terry worked on a radio show and did nearly 500 shows. Is there anybody here who has never heard the Terry Anderson radio show? Good. There's a lot of people who have commented on Terry's passing, and it was a little bit difficult to find any words that I had not already heard. But Tom Tancredo did a very, very good job, I thought, of encapsulating a thought on Terry, and I'm going to use those words here. Terry was never invited to a state dinner in the White House, nor a beer summit in the Rose Garden, nor a televised conversation with Charlie Rose. He made no money from his radio program, and he depended on gifts to stay on the air. It seems corporate advisors in Los Angeles were extremely gun-shy when it came to affiliating openly with a black maverick who advocated passionately for the rule of law. That's apparently too controversial for Home Depot and In-N-Out Burger. That hit it pretty well for me. I have not checked this with management, but I think they will hear about it. I would like to respectfully suggest that some type of an award or memorial be created, perhaps titled the Terry Anderson Award for Effectiveness in Fighting Illegal Immigration. I think that's a good, solid idea. An unforgettable man deserves to have his name mentioned here every year. And again, I'm sure management will find out what I've suggested and let me know about it later.
Can I nominate Carol Helm this year?
Yeah, I like it.
Again, a picture is worth a thousand words. This is nothing close to what I spent preparing. Terry Anderson is gone, and I can't believe that. Again, it's our great loss. I hope you never forget him. I never will. Terry leaves behind a loving family, 3 grown sons, his wife Melanie, who he adored, and grandchildren. And I only have one negative thing to say about my very, very dear friend, Terry Anderson. He's been in my home multiple times, and when he comes, we would always eat a big breakfast, including the day of the ice storm. But as a Southerner, I have to note, Terry Anderson would not eat grits. And he didn't care who knew it. Thank you very much for listening to me. Terry deserved more.
You ready, Fred? Let me just say one quick thing before you start, if you could. I want to say about Terry, I want to share one thing that I knew about him. My brother works for NBC in Los Angeles, and he didn't know I had any connection with Terry. And when Terry died, you know, he called me on the phone. He said, Casey, we lost a great guy out here. His name was Terry Anderson. And so then I was able to tell him that I had the privilege of knowing Terry for a long time. But I want to say the one thing about Terry that was very powerful to me is that he was like Ronald Reagan in that he had an unshakable belief in the goodness of this country and of its people and of his community. And he wasn't going to let anybody run over that. And and that was one of the things that just came through to me like a huge sledgehammer when you were around Terry, is that he would take on anybody that was going to be attacking his community, his state, his country, and his people. That's what he believed in, and he was a great guy. We lost him. Yeah.